What's up, guys? Steve Mayeda here with the TSL Podcast, and we are live on our Men's Development Excellence call. It's the 30th of August, and what we're talking about is why we fail. And what we're actually going to talk about is the techniques, the different situations that we get us in to get out of failure, but more importantly, the real thing which keeps you out of failure. So I know this happens all the time with guys. We're failing at something with our work, our job, dating, sex, women, our relationships, how to make more money, how to create more of a following, and so on. And we always look at the solution right away, but there's a deeper level to that. And that's what we're getting to in this podcast. Now, like I said, this is being recorded live. We're on a call right now. And these guys, there's actually 12 people. It's 9:47 p.m. in Austin, Texas. And we have 12 guys who are hashing it out on the call. So much to the point where they said, hey, Steve, go and record your thing. We're going to talk. So that's a pretty awesome community. If you're interested in any form of men's development, bettering yourself with your mind, your body, your sex, your relationships, this is the place to do it. Please do it somewhere. But hey, if you don't have anywhere, go to our MD Excellence group or check out our AMD Plus group where I'm streaming this live as well. So let's get into this. Failure. Oh my God. Man, it is such a thing that we run from in our culture, such a thing that, you know, is painful. We hate it. You know, whenever we fail as a man, we feel so much like less of a man. There's really no room for it in our culture, and we're seen as a lesser person if those things are happening. It's really, really it's a taboo even. So to be a failure or to fail at something or to show that sort of weakness as a man, you feel inadequate. It's one of the biggest black eyes that we have. But one thing that we look for is so much is that how do we fix this and how do we fix it in the quickest way possible? Now, this actually gets in the way of our actual solution. And I'll tell you why. Because so much of our failure is due to the different social pressures we have, how we're going to look, who we are as a man, how this is going to show our performance or prove, how we, really are the person that's never going to get it done. And we hit into all these different beliefs. So many times we go to the opposite of that. Like, for instance, if our goal is to make $1 million, we have a fear about being poor. If our goal is to have 1 million followers or have a lot of adoration, that's pointing to the pain that we have of feeling that we might be inadequate in certain ways, or we're not getting validation in certain ways. Or if we want to have a bunch of women worship us, that is a reflection of our fear that we're alone or that we are inadequate with women. So our failures or our fear of failing point directly to what a lot of our fears and internal beliefs are. It's really a crazy thing. We don't look at that enough. So we look towards the solution. We say, hey, how do I make $1 million? How am I going to do it? How am I going to get motivated? How am I going to get focused? How am I going to move towards certain things in my life where I will be impervious to failing, to not having that window to look at myself and so on? And that's great. We can get it, and perhaps you'll get some results in those, and you can share about them and talk about how great it is to no longer fail. However, we are stuck with those beliefs. And this is why we fail. This is why no matter what result we get, and in fact, getting a favorable result that gets you past that fear of failure can actually work against you. All right, it's one of the worst things actually that can happen to you. So for instance, if you're a guy and you want to date tens or date really hot women or have all this adoration from certain people in your life, and this is your big, big goal, and you get that, and you have not fixed the drivers within you that say, oh my God, being alone hurts so bad. Oh my God, seeing other men with women hurts so bad. Oh my God, I am never going to be able to date the women that I want. Man, that is a tragedy. Because we learn this crazy, crazy path of getting results, of getting rewarded for something that we're not even that person. You know, we can't be the actual guy that gets tens. We can't be the actual guy that gets $1 million. We can't be this guy that we so strive to be, that our pain looks for, that the hero that we strive for, that we need to be that. We can never be that because we still have that fear in us. And so this is an important thing, and this is where the turn in our conversations tonight on our call actually took, is that we need to look at all the things that we're afraid to look at within ourselves. We need to look at the things we love about ourselves, but the things we hate about ourselves. And most guys haven't done that. This is one of the most beneficial exercises that at least I got from recovery. And when I talk about recovery, this is addiction recovery, 12-step recovery. And you don't even have to believe in that, or maybe you had a bad experience with it, which I can totally understand. But we look at those things, and these are freaking huge in our development. When I can face the things that perhaps I hate about myself, that I fear the most about myself, that if I found out that other people knew about me would just terrify me, if I can face those things and be at peace with them, then I become an expression. And see, here's the difference with it, is that when I look at like, oh my God, man, I have shame over not being successful. I have shame over not being popular. I have shame over not being judged. That I will feel terrible about that. I'll feel hurt in my soul towards it. It will make me feel back to when I was a kid and left alone and so on, and all these different memories that I have that are attached to that shame. But when I can look at it, it still may hurt me. It still may hurt me when I'm rejected. It still may hurt me when I'm alienated from a different group, or when I don't fit in, or when success doesn't go my way. But it no longer goes into this elaborate story of how I'm destined to be that guy. So that when I go and look to pursue the different things that I have, like let's say I want to make $1 million. Let's say I want to get 1 million followers. Let's say I want all this adoration. Let's say I want sex and relationships with the most beautiful women in the world. But I walk in that without the shame motivating it. The only thing then can motivate me is my expression. My true pursuit, my true human goal for that. And we seem to think that that isn't so valuable. Why? Because our society sees these big bright lights and shiny stuff, because our society promotes a culture which is just this amazing, you know, thing that is oh my God, like larger than life, and that we could have it. Well, that only looks attractive to a guy that doesn't like his own life. Whereas another person who's secure in himself says, man, that's good. I could take a walk in those shoes. That might be a cool vacation. That might be something there. But I have pride in who I am. So in part of the road to not failing, and part of the road to being somebody that is happy with their life, is you have to get happy with who you are. Look at yourself. And as the suggestion we made on the call is, start off with a list. Write about the things that you love about yourself and really get into it, and write about the things that you hate about yourself. And in that list, there's going to be something that comes about where you're going to start to dig. So at first, the things I hate about myself, well, I hate that, you know, I don't have as much motivation. I hate that I don't perform at work. I hate that my boss doesn't, you know, give me the respect. And these sorts of things might come out, but it's going to get deeper. Man, I hate that I felt bad when somebody stepped on my toes. I hate that I look at myself in such a disgusting way and that I want to cry when, you know, somebody talks shit about me. I hate that when I want to talk to somebody and just can't, I feel it in my throat and I almost want to just burst out in tears or start yelling or getting really angry about something. Like, we start to get into this deeper level of things, which we need to realize is, especially when we have a group of people and we have a good support system, we have a network like we have in our groups, but you could be in whatever group and accomplish this just as long as you have that accountability there. Man, you realize that this isn't going to hurt you. You realize that you can look at the things that you fear most about yourself, your beliefs, and you don't have to run. You don't have to be in pain. You don't have to fear them and think that if those come out, that makes it your destiny to never succeed in your life. So if we think about this, why do we fail? We fail because we haven't really absolved the problems within ourselves. We fail because we haven't been willing to be ourselves and see ourselves and even take responsibility for who we are. And what a beautiful thing, because when we do take responsibility for who we are, when we can be ourselves in our own skin, then all things like pleasure, like your sense of awareness, like your sense of who you are, all become a free flowing expression of you. Why would you turn that down? And there's actually probably plenty of reasons for that. But it's a great, great thing, and it's a great thing to work for. And that is the natural result of what we do. In any case, guys, thank you so much for listening. Be sure and subscribe to our YouTube channel. We have tons of different stuff. This was a podcast that was done and recorded live. And so it's all done in one take. And it's just off the top of our head. And we probably discussed this for about an hour and a half before we press the record button. But that's how these things go. If you want to be on our calls or if you want to be a part of the different expressions that we have, man, check out what we have here. Check out, make sure it's a great decision for you. Look at our playlists. Look at the different types of webinars we put out or the different types of presentations that we have that we put out through Austin Men's Development or TSL. It's a beautiful thing. Look, we believe in communication and also giving the right information for men to evolve to be their best self. And that is what we've been doing. But we want to broadcast it to the world, to you guys. So come by, interact with us, click that free stuff link down below, get our different PDFs, join our free groups. And hey, if it's something that you like, join our paid groups and be a part of what we're doing. In any case, Steve Mayeda signing off. You guys have a good day and we'll talk to you guys soon.